Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Rising. Happy Friday. Sagar, what are we doing?
We have an amazing show for everybody today. We've got Bob Cusack, Hill's editor-in-chief, Governor Mark Sanford, who's challenging President Trump on the Republican side. CNN forgot Andrew Yang again on a graphic. Literally can't make this up.
They never learn.
And Joe Biden's got some new fundraising numbers, and we're going to tell you all about that. Yeah. All that coming up today on Rising. All right, Krystal, what's on your radar?
Well, Joe Biden is out with his fundraising numbers for Q3. These, of course, coming at a critical moment for his campaign. He's under new scrutiny for various family members cashing in on their access to him. And Biden's been on such a downward slide in the polls that he is now only 2 points ahead of Warren in RCP's national average. So what better way to shore up support and have a show of strength coming into the next debate than posting a big fundraising number? Prove he's still the big man on campus. I mean, after all, he's been hitting that fundraising circuit hard, even sticking with an oil exec fundraiser he took heat on during the climate change forum. According to NBC News, Biden ramped up his fundraising schedule big time from Q2 to Q3, going from 24 to 43 big dollar events. That's a whole lot of money groveling. It's all worth it, though, if you've got that sweet, sweet campaign cash just ready to be deployed to bludgeon poor, unsuspecting Iowans who are just trying to watch John Spicer humiliate himself on Dancing with the Stars. So, did Biden keep himself in respectable frontrunner cash haul range? Drum roll, please. This quarter, Biden raised a whopping $15.2 million. Ladies and gentlemen, that is pathetic. It's a massive drop-off from the $22 million he raised in Q2. For heaven's sake, a socialist scraping together donations from Walmart workers at $18 a pop outraised him by a full $10 million. Dude, you realize next quarter, Andrew Yang is going to raise more than you. Have your aides even briefed you on who that is yet? Here's what we know so far for the quarter. Bernie's top of the pack so far at $25 million. We're still waiting on Warren's numbers to come in. I expect her to hit a really big number as well. I thought Mayor Pete's number was a little rough until I saw Biden's. The truth is, Biden's campaign is starting to stink. And it's a huge problem for him. Just in terms of the fundraising numbers, it's going to be really hard for him to get it back on track. It's not like the people who are ponying up Biden campaign cash are all in for the principle of the thing. Now, I'm sure some genuinely really like him, but I'd be willing to bet his strongest fundraising vein has been the transactional type, the people who just want to back the winner so they can get their ambassadorship or their particular goodie snuck in a bill or just the ego stroking of occasionally having the president phone them. You have no idea how much the photos and White House Christmas party invites motivate these people. But it's an even worse sign for the campaign itself. Biden's maintained his position despite debate performances that have ranged from lackluster to downright offensive, minimal campaigning, and no vision really other than Trump bad, Obama good, because people thought he was a winner. This is what Democrats have told pollsters over and over again. They want the solid guy to solidly win the primary and solidly beat Trump. These numbers, coming at this moment, are anything but solid. On the contrary, it looks weak. No energy, falling in the polls, and now no fundraising juice. That's to say nothing of the fact that Democrats brilliantly decided to put his family's standard issue, Washington corruption, at the heart of their Trump impeachment probe. You literally cannot make this stuff up. Needless to say, if Bernie saw this kind of fundraising fall off, the calls for him to drop out would be deafening. I think the truth for Biden is that he missed his moment. There was a lane for him last time around before Trump radicalized everyone in various ways, before Bernie forced the party to actually stand for something, and frankly, before Joe was 4 years older. Hillary was obviously a much weaker of a candidate than anyone thought. Joe's middle-class shtick could have played pretty well against Hillary's Goldman Sachs shtick. But here we are with Biden's campaign, like its fundraising numbers, crashing into the rocks and crushing the dreams of status quo neoliberals everywhere. Maybe I should take another look at Beto or something. Sagar, we're talking about this. We didn't think his numbers were going to be amazing. You said the bar was 20 million. Yeah. This is way worse than I could have imagined.
Yeah, I said yesterday, oh, if he falls below 20 million, I really think it's a problem. And I was expecting maybe like 17,
like 18, 19.
$15 million. That's one third more than Andrew
Yang's nipping at your heels.
It's a disaster.
So bad.
It's a total disaster. I mean, I said from this beginning, he's basically made his campaign a one-legged stool, which is Trump is bad, and I'm the only person person who can beat him. So the moment that leg gets kicked out from under him, he's done. He's got nothing else to fall back on. And add on top of that, I mean, you literally have negative pressure at this point on this campaign. The Hunter Biden stuff, the fact that he just seems so wildly out of touch. We've talked about it here so many times, and it looks like people are starting to wake up. The real question is, how is he possibly going to raise more money next time? He's tapped the well. It's dry.
It's going to be even harder next time around, because the reality is these elite donors, and, you know, I've talked to these people. Mm-hmm. I know these people. They really would prefer, like, someone whip smart like Buttigieg with that resume, et cetera. That's who they really want. They kind of have contempt for Biden, but they went along with him because they thought, okay, well, this is the guy we have to back. Now that that support looks soft, it's going to be a big problem to get it back up. And as we know, he pulled all his online ads, more or less. He clearly wasn't gaining any grassroots traction. So
not great.
Not good.